Good morning, church. Today is day number 7 of our 40 days of prayer for the gospel to every home. And happy 4th of July, by the way. I hope you have some exciting things prepared as we get after we gather together for worship this morning. Today, our scripture is found in Acts chapter 1, verse 8. It says, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." And today specifically, we're praying for great awakening and revival in our land. We live in a day and age where it's hard for us to be Christians, where it's hard for us to live out the faith that was once for all delivered to the saints. But nonetheless, we know that in some of the most persecuted areas of the world, even right now today, is where God is working the most. I hear stories from people in South Asia all the time about them being persecuted, but also at the same time, God is growing His church exponentially in those areas despite the persecution. Sometimes I think us as American Christians, we're just a little too comfortable at times. But I pray specifically today that God would awaken me to rely fully on His Spirit, not to rely just simply on my talents and my giftedness. And I pray the same for you, that you would not rely upon your talents and giftedness, but you would just live your life in obedience with His Spirit and just allowing His Spirit to lead you as you follow Him each day. And so let's pray together specifically for two things. I want to pray specifically for our church today, but I also want to pray specifically for us as a church and a witness in our world today, and specifically in America. So let's pray. Father, we thank you for just the awesomeness of living in such a wonderful place. Lord, there are so many around the world that would love to be a part of the United States of America, to have the freedoms that we have. But Lord, we recognize that sometimes the freedoms that we have can be a breeding ground for complacency in our churches. I've seen it. I've seen brothers and sisters around the world in South Asia and Eastern Europe in some places, Lord, where Lord, persecution is a real and deadly thing. And they love you and they serve you even despite what the government says. And Lord, I pray, Lord, that you would break the chains of our complacency. I pray that specifically for our church, Lord, that you would awaken us, Lord, that your Spirit would awaken us and help us to rely firmly upon your good news, no matter what the culture wants to tell us. And I pray that for the American church, Lord, that you would break the chains of our cultural Christianity, that it would be less about what we want and more about what Jesus desires to do in our lives and through our churches. And so bring revival to us today. I pray, Lord, specifically for our service today, Lord, that you will bring a powering sense of your Spirit in our worship service this morning, but that you would do the same thing in sister churches throughout this land today, that you would bring true revival and awakening, leading many people to saving faith in Christ. And we ask it in Jesus' name.